Alright, hello viewers and current lessons in the past, present, and future. I wonder if you can promote. See, there's a percentage completed now. By the way, Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. I got it today. And I've done the first level so far. Because that's all I've had time to do. I got it downloaded right before I had to go to work, so I'm back now. Streaming. I'm gonna see how far I can get in Legends mode and possibly do some adventure map. Now, the 3DS version, I wanted 100% it. That was a bit too much to ask from a system that is that was about to be replaced at the time with the Switch. So, that was probably a mistake. I got 150 hours dedicated to that version. Almost had the first adventure map 100% on there. But the thing is, I was also like, I also had most of the Great Sea map done. I had progress in everything. I decided this time around I'm dedicating all my time to the first adventure map, which is 100%. Then I'm gonna move on to the other ones. I'm gonna go through them like that. I'm gonna change the name of the stream. Right now we're doing Legends mode. For a while. Challenge mode. I have never done challenge mode because that was not in the 3DS version. What is in here? See, these are gonna be fun. Yeah, because those I've never even started. I need to get a fairy to get my fairy mode, which I don't know if you can even get fairies in Legends mode. Because I think these are just copied and some pastes from the Wii U version, besides, you know, the ability to change characters and stuff. And fairies weren't a thing in those, so I don't know if actually we have those included. I did not. Shoot. Okay. There's a lot of levels. Like, just the total amount of DLC and the Legends mode that all those levels brought together. There is so many levels in Legends mode. We're not gonna get anywhere near getting all of them done. I'm gonna be doing them off stream. This isn't a stream series by any means. I just wanted to stream the game. I just thought it'd be fun if I streamed the game while I was also playing it on the side. I'll probably be doing a lot of streams of this game if I'm planning on 100%ing it. If I want to keep up daily streaming in the future. And I'm going to also be trying to 100% this freaking game. I'm going to need to stream it a couple times. So, I don't know everything that they got rid of in the Wii U version, for the 3DS version. I knew that there was animations for defeating every single boss for every single character, or at least breaking their weak point. That was not in the 3DS version. Every character just kind of held up their hands as the boss went flying. In this game, I knew it was there, but I kind of forgot about it while fighting King Ghidorah. It amazed me. When Link decided to jump up and stab him through his neck, and I'm like, holy Jesus! So then I'm excited to see those, because I haven't seen any of those animations. At least I don't remember them. I used to watch videos of this game all the time. I should probably pay attention to what I'm typing so I can get into this, because I'm talking more than I'm typing. Also, I'm thirsty, and I have no water. Be right back. Okay. Oof. Oh, sorry you had to hear that. Now, after 5 minutes of not doing anything, without further ado, let's get into it. Elden Caves. Already finished that. Yeah, list of playable characters, shoot. I meant to do all of them in easy mode. All the levels in easy mode. I'll redo this one sometime. Because, I want to go through every single level for my first time in easy mode, then I'll go through them all again in normal mode, then I'll go through them all in hard mode. Because you can see the checkmark, I wish that when you did normal, it also checked off everything below it. Or if you did hard, it checked off everything below it. But no, you gotta play in easy mode for all of them, so I'm just gonna get that out of the way my first playthrough, alright? Just, I gotta redo the levels and then. Probably sometime this stream. But right now, I'm on new stuff. I mean, I guess I'll choose Empire. I probably can change characters in the middle of this.
After an arduous battle, Link and his comrades slew King Dodongo, but the beast was only ever intended as a distraction. The army of monsters had taken Hyrule Castle. Worse, after the dust had settled, Princess Zelda was nowhere to be found. Impa and Link searched the battlefield for any sign of her, but to no avail. Although the battle had been lost, Impa foresaw Link's importance to the coming war. She bestowed upon him a green tunic, the sign of the legendary hero. Link did not believe himself worthy of the honor, but he was determined to help Impa and her remaining soldiers locate Zelda. Weeks passed. Impa heard a rumor that a handful of soldiers were holding out against the monsters in Farron Woods. The leader of this resistance was supposedly a young woman. Impa dared to hope that this unknown woman was Zelda. Link and Impa decided to make their way to the forest by way of the Elden Caves, a path with its own dangers.
Alright. Let's see what we got here. I remember I've probably done every single one of these levels, like, twice maybe. I never liked replaying them. I loved adventure mode. These levels just took way too long for my taste. So I guess we're starting off really small. I'm guessing the enemies are going to appear as we're going. Right now it's literally us two and a Hyling captain way up there. That's weird. Whatever. Okay. Cool. We have no defeat conditions. No matter what happens, we can't lose. Apparently. But yeah, like I've said, I've played through these levels a couple times, so I know what I'm doing. For the most part, I mean, it's been a long time, I haven't really played through them that much, but I know what I'm doing at least. Oh, I love the music though. Oh, Hyrule Warriors music is so good. I'm gonna turn up the Elgato on you guys. I'm sorry if it's too loud, but you guys need to hear this music. Oh, hey! Freaking missed. Wonderful. God, I'm so used to looking down at a touch screen to see where I'm going next. I have to look up in the top right corner rather than looking down. Everything is just all over the screen instead of being just on the touch screen. If I want to know anything about what's happening, I always need to look at the bottom screen, but it's all just displayed throughout the top screen now. The only screen, I should say. I know everything about this game. I don't need no tutorials. Actually, people might not know that this game, they might be watching for that. Super Star Game Awards game, I don't know. It's hard to explain how the games are to people. You kill a lot of enemies, and there's a war happening. God, I want to be able to use so much more combo, but I need to unlock it all first. Seeing this game in HD looks so nice though. Like, it it's unnecessary. Like, it doesn't make the Wii version than the 3DS better than 3DS version. The 3DS version has a lot more content, it's worth it. But it's so awesome to see all that content actually in HD. That's cool stuff. There. Sick, my friend in the Wii version says it's superior. I'm like, no, it's not! 3DS version better. Wii U version inferior in every way, okay. I'm gonna save this poor dude over here. It's much more like following the rules than the Wii clones. Like I'm used to. I'm used to Legend Mode, but not Legends Mode. Adventure Mode. We basically just do whatever you want. While doing, you know, the main, one main objective, but there's a lot of, like, go do this, go do this, go do this, go do this in the battlefield, like. So I'm gonna be not always following exactly what they want me to do, because I'm not used to doing that. I'm used to just doing whatever. Oh, crap, these guys' faces. They did not look like that on the 3DS version. So many different enemies. So many more in the 3DS version. 3DS version had no camo. It was okay. I mean, it's better with more enemies. But it's worth it! For more content! But there's more content in this version, so it's alright. Okay, finally capture the monster spawn and keeps. Alright. See, now all the monsters have spawned. Alright, bomb shoes. This is the level with the bomb shoes. I remember the bow is the level you need to drop the pillars. Yeah, I keep. Sometimes I'll just walk by those. Because, in Legends version, I had 999 of all these, like. I don't know what they call them, like sergeant types. Like, they're not quite the big guys that you can actually lock onto. Because all these guys got materials, they're just basic style children. Just, you know, a bit bigger. The only ones you can lock onto are at least the outpost captain ones. But their materials I had 999 of. Every version of them. Right, there's other players. You can change characters and stuff. Right. See, I feel like I'm playing the Wii version though, so I'm not trying to change characters or anything. Like, I got used to being able to do that while playing the TV, because I have played the Wii version. Like, an okay amount. Probably like, maybe 10 hours total. Sure, when I played it at my friend's house. Probably more than that. And because of that, I'm kind of gonna treat, I might treat it like that version and not use the things we do. Not command. I'm just gonna tell Link to defend that bomb shoe. Ow. Frick. Is that the other side of it? Oh, I think I know where it is. Cellphone makes really weird noises. They did not make these noises in the 3DS version. I don't know if they made it in the 3DS version. But I would have noticed. There's no noises on the 3DS version. Alright, go and bomb chicken. You're all good. You're clear. Semi-clear. Clear enough. Go. Go. Oh, I think I had to open the gate. I tried walking up that. Alright, Link, let's go. Let's go over there somewhere. Alright, now we got Sheik. Oh, we can't change to her right now. But there she is. Sheik has such a cool playstyle though. Like, I really want to meet her sometime. Dude, 1,000? I already have 1,300. Jeez. Happened fast. Okay. Link, go over here. I don't think I can push forward actually until we take this out, so I have a bomb here today. Look at that. What could this be? A weapon. I think I know what that is actually. Maybe, I'm not sure. Alright, so take out this summoner Link. Go take out the other summoner. Wait, what? Can I forget the summoner? I guess not. Okay, that's weird. I actually go to South Square because that kind of whole corner of the map's been taken back. I kind of want to go back. Oh shoot. I can't get up there.
Watch out!
Frick, okay. Okay. Let's see this spirit they speak of. Here's the summoner. Yeah, I don't know, quick captain. Good, good. Wait, he's definitely more awesome. Hey. I guess I'm... Oh wait, Link's almost there. So I'll play a Sheik. Impo's gonna go and take on a... assault troop. I'll actually switch them. Whoops. Okay. Easy to know when you're changing it when you're tapping off screen. Just go inside small square and defend it. Drag more stones in our way. Darn it. Alright. It's just kind of running like that while I looked at the map to see where to go next. Now he's looking at a corner man. Took me a second to analyze it. It's a lot smaller than it is on the PS version. If you know we're in the corner rather than a full screen. Okay, so I'm pretty much thinking about this full one. Actually,
what are you doing up here? Playing Pokemon Day like all the bits?
Yeah, I think you can see how encountered they are when you command them. Sometimes they do not do damage to you. Most of the time they do, but good lord. Please shoot the ass of you. Take assault troops. So what are the side missions do we have? I'm not used to checking out side missions because I only do adventure mode. How do I do it? I guess I'll head all over the place finding this stuff, because there's three keeps that they seem to want me to take right now, so. I'll dedicate one person to each, about. Exactly like it is the PS version, and I come out of it and it's like, holy crap, this is not the PS version. This looks nice. Such a pleasant surprise. Where's the over here? Okay, let's think. I'll switch to Link now so that I can let her do that. Okay, so it wasn't on this doctor, so it's gonna be where? I think this going right now. There you go, we found it. Sorry, well, I was wondering, whatever. I think it's going right now, actually. Get a little bit of that first, and then I can do this question now. Go! Alright. Even the little guys hit you. Make it to stop and stagger. Can't wait till I get that defense badge. That makes that, you know, not happen. Let's see what we got. Cool. Send the bomb to you specifically. Square. Impa can't leave. Okay, well now she's out. Oh, where was I gonna ever go? Oh yeah, West Square. Defend it. Alright, then Sheik to take this. Whisper. guess. Okay, she now... Go to Winslow, I guess. Okay, putting a hit look on the, palm tree already, because it needs some defending right now. So where's the other bounty then? Remember there's another one. Here we go. Wait, I don't really think I have info doing anything specific right now. Oh yeah, helping out. Yeah. Let's go fight those outposts just so I have to do something. Corner me with a hit. Oh man, fire is OP. This round is so new, like, this is sick. Hit you freaking everywhere. Right, I was trying to think of the material, but nope, it's not gonna work. Okay. Gotta do a special animation move. He's a special character. He's not actually dead yet. They gotta let you know. Okay, most of those guys I saw were friends. I used that thing and then it was full of enemies. Okay, we'll go. Here we go. Yeah, I can try to do a boss fight, yeah. I'm assuming that that would be a boss fight. Epa. Yo. What's up? Alright, cool. Alright, hey. Here we go. Good. She's just gone. Here we go, we win. Hey. fire on. I thought that's what the weapon I got was. And another illustration part. Cool. I guess I'm gonna be getting a lot of those medals towards the start here. Alright, Sorcerers of the Woods. So we're heading into Faron Woods now. Let's go. Guess I'll play a sheep mainly.
Link and his allies were saved from the dangers of the Elden Caves by a mysterious youth named Sheik. Joined by their new ally, Impa's troops exited the caves and emerged in Faron Woods. There, they found a hidden village overrun with monsters. While Link and Impa wanted to continue their search for Zelda, they could not ignore the plight of the villagers. Without hesitation, they sprang into battle.
Didn't even consider that the lady could be in here. I remember I loved these for the stage. Oof. Alright. Yep, I think this was it. I like all of these in this game. It's a great soundtrack. Whoa! Oh, I don't have any arrows. I was trying to change weapon to my bow and arrow, and I'm like, I don't have one. I haven't got it yet. Yeah, I think I'm going to review it and upload this day. Dude, these enemies did not make noise in the 3DS version. I think the enemies might have just not made noise in general. In the 3DS version, I just never really noticed. Oh, if they want me to throw the deck of bones, I kinda can't. And the bone arrows. Okay. And this is definitely something I wanna do. Just, blaze through that. Thought I remember them being down here. Yep. Cool. Oops. Thank you. up. It's fine. Here we go. Deku Babu have done it, so... Oh, fix that, you're gonna keep doing the combo, but nope, I don't have the combo unlocked yet. Hey, Gibdy. Freaking HD. Fight that Gibdo, I just kinda wanna get it from doing something specific. There we go, defeat Wizro. I think we should have Link constantly in the Deku Tree ready to defend. I think I got frozen. Jin's character. That's my solution from now on. Whenever I get frozen, just change characters. Use cards when you get out of being frozen. Okay, Jake, I'm finding out on accident. Okay. And so technically, he's kind of sick. Summon Gibby. That's a lot of enemies. 76. Whoa. That's a nice number. I like that. Definitely like more than you could ever get in the 3DS version. To even appear. When you have your screen at least. Oh, jeez, this guy has no turn. Yes! You know, I forgot that was even a thing in the 3DS version. I mean, I knew it was a thing in the 3DS version, but I forgot that was a thing that would have come over here. Okay. Sculpture that comes first. Nope. take a lot longer to charge than that in the Legends version. I did it against like a wall, almost. It was not very well done. Whatever. It's all bad. I think these guys freaking gobbles. Oh no. They've set fire to the Tree of Deku. It was a bad. Where did you come from, though? Fire. Alright, where's the third? That fire looks beautiful. On the inside. This is a Gibdo. Well, I assumed it was that one, but, like, it's closed, so... Open the door. Well, not usually something that the player can just, you know, do on command. There we go. You don't want to attack your freaking cuckoos. There we go. Just waiting for the cutscene to start. Look at that. It's a rain cloud. Dude, he's got some fungus growing on him, dude. You got some acne. Crystal was way different in the system of this version. I don't think it's this way in the Wii U version. But I feel like they did. I didn't know if I had my last card up, but I usually don't use the cards anyways. And then I try again. The wizard got away. Ah, Gomba. Cool boss that we need the item that I just got to defeat. Hey there, bugger. What's up? Down him again. Ooh. Oh, I see what the thing does when I break its meter. What if it does to it? Damn it. Oh, he just freaking jumped to the middle. I guess we're gonna see what Link does. Oh, it freaking reset. Alright, we win. That was a short game, I think. Anyways. Thought it didn't last very long. So, this is some echo.
For generations, Hyruleans have told the tale of the war across the ages. This is how it begins. Deep in the forests, far from mortal eyes, a great sorceress watched over the balance of the Triforce. Through her magic, she could see across ages, able to read the fates of all who lived, but never interfering. That is, until a unique soul caught her attention. The soul of the hero of legend, eternally reborn when Hyrule's need is greatest. Through her powers, the sorceress should have seen that the hero was bound to another. Instead, she saw only a soul that was unlike any she had known. And while the sorceress was preoccupied, a fragment of darkness, locked in its prison, saw an opportunity. The whispering darkness wormed its way into her heart. It pushed the light away and warped her curiosity into a desperate desire to possess the legendary hero's soul. Of course, this evil had its own desires. To use the Triforce to resurrect itself and conquer Hyrule once again. Having pushed the light from her heart, the darkness compelled her to open the Gate of Souls, the doorway of time itself. Monsters from across the ages pour through the gate, bringing ruin to the land of Hyrule once more.
So that's how it all happened. After how this game is quite the story. I want to play this game on my own. The other is leveled up. Okay. Is that a thing in the Legends version? I don't remember that ever happening. I love how the bizarre based on illustrations. It might have. I don't remember though. I'm sure I did. So we can start Lucas' story now. Actually, I'm going to do Lucas to start Lucas' story, then I'm going to end it. Video and stream and stuff. But first I'll show off my Linkle skills. Actually, I'm not gonna have very many Linkle skills right now. Unless I can, yeah, I can't. I don't even have ever gotten enough to, okay. Yeah, I don't have many of for combos. But here's her story. In HD for the first time.
Oi!
Huh?
Oi!
was a girl who lived in a small village. She led a simple life, tending to her flock of cuckoos. Her name was Linkle. For as long as she could remember, Linkle had believed in her heart that she was the hero reborn. One day, terrible news arrived at her village. Monsters had laid siege to Hyrule Castle. Linkle caught word of the monster's attack and immediately began preparations. She dressed the part in her green tunic. Equipped with her trusty crossbows and the ancient compass her grandmother had bestowed on her, Linkle set out from the village. This treasured compass and a crude map were all she had to guide her way to Hyrule Castle. In no time at all, she found herself lost in a malevolent forest. An imp in a curious mask appeared out of nowhere and stole Linkle's precious compass. That compass, she knew, was proof of her destiny. She had to get it back. And thus began Linkle's first true trial.
All right. Linkle is my main, as she should be everyone's, because she's OP as frick. So we're gonna go on the same map we were just on. To fight a Skull Kid. And her army is cuckoos. It's just cuckoos. I love it. But see, her fifth combo is what makes her OP, so I'm not gonna actually do too well here. I love how it just said that an imp stole her compass. Next thing you know, there's an all-out war being waged in the forest between a bunch of skeletons and cuckoos. And apparently these two people are the leaders of the two hens. Just, what is happening here? Alright. Get this outpost taken. What am I supposed to be doing here? There's no objective in the bottom right now. I've just kind of taken over everything that I can. And, what do I do now? Oh, well, the meter in this version is actually a crossbow. The crossbow shoot meter. Do this thing. I think we should shoot that against boss characters. Where does it want me to go? This character is quickly gonna get to a very high level, and the latest version I think I left her at like level 120 or something like that. Somewhere in the lower hundreds. Oh wait. I don't notice I can go this way. What's the thing that I got for this one? He's home right now. I just dodged through him after he died and hit one of the bullets back. Wow. Magic bullet thingies. Oh yeah, I remember how this level was. Disappears. I wonder how you actually carry. I'm assuming it's probably. I keep trying to execute the combo too. break, I can like this level. Mr. Gatekeeper, prepare your friend.
Ow.
Let's go cook it. Yeah, I need to get some ammo.
Oh, material.
Materials are impotent. Okay, seeing as there's a bit of a blockage there, I'm just gonna. Oh shoot, it's my first time doing this in the HD version. So that looked very awkward to me. I use the touchscreen usually for doing that. I think there's one of these in every single level. One of these escort chick. Cookie chick. It already? Okay. Jerk. Like, I wonder how changing characters works in 2-player mode and teleporting and stuff. I wonder how all that stuff works in 2-player mode, or if it just doesn't. I'm probably gonna, like, start in his account so you can go through the tutorial and everything. After this level, I'll see if he's up. I thought it was before he'd already been. I'm already getting started. I just started her third row of hearts when I was done playing the weapons version. Let's go there. I heard it. There she is. Alright. The rescue cooking trick. Alright. On the way. Ooh. Bring him on. I'm not used to there also being a right stick to move. Like, I mean, there was on a new 3DS and I got a new, I got a new 2DS eventually. gold cooker on it, if you know. That's probably good. There's a bunch of enemies that wants me to see over here. Kills. That's pretty dang good. I mean, let's find out what's down here and see if there is anything. Nothing, alright. So where is Skull Kid? Capture the keep. That's not very specific. But sure, I will capture the keep. Many enemies in here. I'll capture the keep. Okay, starting to spawn. Here they go. Okay, so I'm supposed to be searching the other keeps. Because he's like, nope, not enough keep. Found you, big brick. I've like never played a Skull Kid. I don't like playing this one. Oh, of course you did. I'm gonna kill everything in here because they're really freaking annoying. God, I keep trying to use the OP combo. Where is he now? Don't look at the freaking. Oh my god, Salem, why? Salem. Freaking ruining my stream with Big Gay. Really. Gah. I am surprised over here. Just trying to clip. Because that was kind of funny. Alright, whatever. What the frick is happening? What the heck was the death? Okay, I win. You give me your material. I want it. There we go. All right.
Link left her village, vowing to restore peace to Hyrule. In her hand, she clutched her grandmother's precious compass. But before long, a mischievous imp had stolen the treasured possession. Linkle chased down the imp and tried to retrieve the compass. And then, something strange happened. As if in response to her struggle, the compass began emitting a mysterious light. It seemed to be reacting to her. Linkle recovered it, hung it from her neck, and vowed never to lose it again. The compass's light was quite a mystery to her. She didn't know what secret power it might hold. Whatever the case, it had to be a sign of her status as the legendary hero. If she could harness this power, perhaps she would fully realize her destiny and save Hyrule. Her faith renewed, Linkle continued her quest.
Video, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.